Hello children, welcome back. Now we will learn how to calculate the interest on drawings under different situation. Here, situation 1. If the date of drawings is not given, then calculate the interest for 6 months. I have given one example. Suppose A and B are partners. A draws 10,000 and B draws 15,000 at an interest 6% per annum. So in this case, you see the date of drawings, particularly on which date A and B draws their money, that is not given. In that particular case, you will calculate the interest for 6 months. See, 10,000 into 6 by 100 into 6 by 12 and 15,000 into 6 by 100 into 6 by 12. The amount which is come, that is to be considered as interest on drawings. Now you have to highlight this particular point, per annum should be there. That means the interest rate is not fixed, means flat rate interest is not calculated over here. It is assumed that the drawings is made at the middle of the year. Next situation, situation 2, you see here, if drawings made at equal interval, and that means a regular basis the drawings is made. Take the example, equal interval means monthly drawings, quarterly drawings, half yearly drawings or yearly drawings, that is called regular basis. Now this is very much important. I have given 3 examples over here under different circumstances. Find out the interest on drawings at the rate of 6% per annum under the following circumstances. A draws 500 at the beginning of each month. Point to be noted, at the beginning of each month. Okay. B draws 6,000 at the end of each quarter. So again, point it, at the end of each quarter. And C draws 1,500 at the middle of each month. These 3 examples we will solve. Now how to find out the interest on drawings? See the formula. Interest on drawings is equal to TD into R by 100 into AP by 12. Now I explain here. TD means total drawings. Means throughout the year the amount of total drawings that is to be calculated, that is called total TD. Next, rate. R is equal to rate of interest. Here it is given, you see, at 6%. Clear? So 6% we have to consider. The rate is 6. And AP, average period. This is most important. How will you calculate average period? See, the formula is time left after first drawings plus time left after last drawings, whole divided by 2. I repeat. Time left after first drawings plus time left after last drawings whole divided by 2. This is the formula for finding out AP. Now, I am giving one example. You take this example, that is to be better. Okay. See, A draws 500 at the beginning of each month. So, if we consider the year as a calendar year, means it is starting from 1st January and year ending is 31st December. Okay, so see, so first drawings made by A on which date? Very simple, the answer is obviously 1st January. So from 1st January to 31st December, time left after first drawings. Time left after first drawing means from 1st January to 31st December, it is 12 months. Got my point? See, here, calculation is here. Average period. Okay? You see, first time left after first drawings is 12. Likewise this, so the last drawings made by A on which date? At the beginning of each month means obviously the last drawing made by A on 1st December. So from 1st December to 31st December, It is 1 month, you see. So you can easily get the average period. So it is come 12 plus 1 divided by 2, that is 13 by 2. This is most important. Okay. Now you solve here. I have solved this problem. See, total drawings. Now total drawings means the at the beginning of each month A draws the money. Clear? Each month. So in a year there are 12 months. So 12 times. Am I right? So for, see, the total drawing should be 500 into 12, that is 6000. And rate that is given 6%. Here you see 6% rate is given. Rate is 6. Now calculate the interest. Go to the formula. What is the formula? Total drawings into rate by 100 into average period by 12. So total drawings is 500 into 12. Rate is 6 by 100. And average period is 13 by 2 into 1 by 12. Now you can write it 6.5 also. That means 6.5 by 12. That you can do. Because you are using calculator. So no problem. So this interest has come. How much? 195. In this manner, second problem solved in same manner. So you see the drawings at the end of each quarter. Now, do not misguide yourself, children. Maximum students give the reply, the one quarter contains 4 months. That is not the correct answer. Clear? So 12 months is there. Clear? And 12 divided by 4, that means 3. Means one quarter consists of 3 months. Point even noted. So how many times B draws the money? 6,000 at the end of each quarter means 4 times, because there are 4 quarters. So the total drawings, you see, total drawings will be 6,000 into 4. Clear? Then rate by 100. Now average period, it is 9 by 2. How you will calculate? See, B draws 6,000 at the end of each quarter. So first quarter begin on which date? 1st January and end in 31st March. It is beginning from 1st January and end 31st March. So 31st March. So from 1st April, or you can say from 31st March, whatever you like, no problem. So from 1st April to 31st December, or from 31st March to 31st December, how many times left? 9 months. You count. April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 9 months. Clear? And the last drawing made by him at the end of each quarter. So, first quarter end 31st March, second quarter 30th June, third quarter 30th September, and obviously the last quarter 31st December. So, last drawings made on which date? 31st December. 31st December. So, there is no time left. That's why it is considered as zero. See? So 9 plus 0 by 2, your average period is 9 by 2. So you put the values over here, 9 by 2 divided by 1 by 12, you will get the here, okay, 540. Next, third, C draws 1500 at the middle of each month. So your first drawings made by him on 15th January, that means half months, after passing half months, he draws the money 15th January. So how many times left? 11.5 months. See here, average period we are finding out 11.5 months. Okay. Then last drawings made by him obviously on 15th December. So from 15th December to 31st December, it will be half months. Half months means 0.5 months. Now 11.5 plus 0.5 whole divided by 2, you will get the average period 6. Now you calculate the interest. Now interest is total drawings 1500 into 12 and rate by 100 and average period is 6. 6 by 12. It comes 540. So at the middle of each month, at the middle of each quarter, in this type of problem, AP always will be 6. Average period always will be 6. When middle is there, then average period will be 6. Please note it down. And last, see, if the drawings made in different dates, here one example given by me, see, the rate of interest is 6% per annum and the date of drawings is given here, 1st February 10,000, 1st April 12,000, clear, 1st September 13 and 31st October 14, then 1st November 7,000 and 31st December 9,000. So how will you calculate the interest in such type of problems? You see, first you have to make this table. Okay, calculation for interest on drawings. The first column you write the date, second column amount of drawings, third column duration. Duration means from the date of drawings to the book closure of accounts. Okay, so we are considering the calendar year, that is 31st December. And product means, you see, the amount of drawings into duration. That means in first case you see 10,000 into 11, the product is come 1,10,000. You see, now, so first February, if the drawings made on 1st February, so the interest we have to calculate for how many months? 11. Likewise, this from 1st April to 31st December, 9 months. From 1st September to 31st December, it is 4 months. Clear. And from 31st October to 31st December, it's 2 months. Now, this is given by me to misguide you. Maximum students do the mistake. You see the date 31st October, then 1st November. So from 31st October to 31st December, it is 2 months. As well as from 1st November to 31st December, it is also 2 months. And last one is also given 31st December. So obviously it should be 0 months. Now see the product, this into this, 1,10,000, this into this, 1,08,000, 13,000 into 4, 52,000, 14,000 into 2, it is at 28,000, then 7,000 into 14,000, then 9,000 into 0 is equal to 0. And summation of this column all is called total product. Total product is 3,12,000. Now the formula you see. Interest, yes, see, interest is equal to total product into rate by 100 into 1 by 12. So total product is 3,12,000 into 6 by 100 into 1 by 12 and it comes rupees 1,560. So in this way, you calculate the interest on drawings under different circumstances. Now children, I have given this homework. When the school will reopen, I will see. These are the homework given by me. Please go through these problems. Thank you. Good morning children. Today you will learn how to calculate the interest on adjusted capital. Now sometimes if adjusted capital is given, then you have to find out the opening capital, then only you can calculate the interest on adjusted capital. Now, adjusted capital means the closing capital. That is after considering all the adjustment, the capital which is come. That is called adjusted capital. Now, which you have done in class 11, you see, here I have written, in the balance sheet, see, first you write the capital, then add net profit, add additional capital, add interest on capital, and then less net loss, less drawings, interest on drawings. So this is the capital finally the figure which is comes, you write it in the outer column, that is called adjusted capital. And the capital which is given in the trial balance, that is opening capital. So now this adjusted capital or closing capital is given, then first you have to find out this opening capital. Then how? Just do the reverse means you have to add the share of loss, you have to add drawings, if interest in drawings is there, you have to add and deduct all these items, that is net profit means share of profits, additional capital, etc. See, Here, one example is given. ABR partners balance of their capital account at the end of the year. See, at the end of the year means that is closing capital are 1 lakh and 2 lakhs respectively. They distributed the profits rupees 40,000 in the ratio of 3:2. Their drawings are as follows: 9,000 by A and 11,000 by B. And then calculate interest on capital at the rate of 10% per annum. Now see the solution. Yes. So see here you see. See capital at the end of the year. A 1 lakh and B 2 lakhs. Then add drawings. A 9,000 and B 11,000. Summation come 1 lakh 9 and 2 lakh 11. Afterwards, you deduct the share of profit. The total profit was there 40,000 and the ratio is given 3:2. So 40,000 you have to distribute between A and B in this ratio. That means here you see the distribution of profit. I have shown here A 40,000 into 3 by 5, that is 24,000, and B 40,000 into 2 by 5, that is 16,000. Now you have to deduct this share of profit, then you will get the capital. So this is called opening capital. Now easily you can find out the interest on capital. So interest rate is given 10%. You see here I have calculated 85,000 into 10 by 100, that is 8,500, and B 1,95,000 into 10 by 100, that is 19,500. So in this manner you have to calculate the interest on adjusted capital. So while solving the problem from any questions, read the question paper carefully and see the status of the capital. Status means whether it is opening capital or it is adjusted capital or it is additional capital. So as per the requirement, we have to calculate the interest on capital.